I've stayed away from certain areas, and one of the areas I've stayed away from is the transition metal area. We've been doing main group ions. Well, you have a couple of ions you can make from iron. One of them's called the ferrous, and one of them's called the ferric. This is using a classic system. So while the ferrous and the ferric tell you it's iron, it's Latin, it doesn't tell you what the charge is. As it turns out, the ferrous ion has a 2+, and the ferric ion has a 3+. The classic system was developed to handle what we call multivalent ions. Iron is a multivalent ion. You can have 2+ ions, you can have 3+ ions. It's not like sodium. When sodium forms an ion, it forms 1+. So the classic system helps dispel that doubt. Okay, well, you can see that both the ferrous and the ferric ions had different charges. But how do you know what the charge is? I mean, perhaps the us in ferrous means 2+. Let's look at the stannous and the stannic ion. Stannous, tin, is 2+. So maybe that holds. Stannic is 4+, not 3+. The us means a smaller charge than the ic. We would like to use something better so you actually know what the charge is instead of memorizing a bunch of charges. So we're going to use the stock system. It was introduced a few decades ago. What it does is it uses Roman numerals to explicitly state the charge on the ion. So, ferrous. How would we name that? Well, it's iron, so we name it the iron 2 ion. That's because the 2 is the charge on it, 2+. The ferric, that becomes iron 3. Stannous becomes tin 2, and stannic becomes tin 4. Now, tin's not a transition metal, I realize that. Remember that I stayed away also from column 4A. We did 1, 2, and 3A cations, 5, 6, and 7A anions. We ignored 8A because those are the noble gases, but then we didn't do anything about 4A. This is what we're going to do. This is how you're going to tell when you use the stock number. You're going to look at the cation. Okay, first it's a cation, all right, so it's a metal. And you're going to ask yourself, is it a transition metal or is it tin or lead? Tin and lead are in column 4A. So the nonmetals in column 4A tend to form molecular substances. And then tin and lead form ionic substances. So if you have an element and it's one of those three, then you're going to use a stock number on it with these three exceptions. There are many other exceptions in the transition metal area. I'm only going to hold you responsible for these three. Silver ion has a 1+ charge. Cadmium and zinc both have 2+ charges. They are not multivalent. Now, once you commit to memory that silver, cadmium, and zinc have charges that you have to remember, then you can use the periodic table. Silver's in 1B, 1+. Cadmium and zinc are both in 2B, 2+. Let's put this into practice. Stock number. We're only going to use it with cations, and only cations in cases where they're multivalent. You can use the stock number for much more than what we're doing here, but it's not commonly done that way anymore. It's more common to do it this way. In other words, just use it for the multivalent cations. So lead 4 ion, you know the charge. It's a 4, and it's lead. It's a metal. You know it's 4+, Pb4+. Mercury 2, you know the charge on that. It is 2+, so it's Hg2+. What if you go from the name? All right, so I see Mn3+. Well, you ask yourself, is it a transition metal? Is it tin or is it lead? Well, it's a transition metal. And you say, okay, it is a transition metal. Is it one of the three? Is it silver, cadmium, or zinc? No, it's not. Therefore, you must use a stock number. So we'll call it the manganese 3 ion. Similar deal, copper. Is it a transition metal? Tin or lead? Yes, it's a transition metal. So use a stock number, copper 1 ion. So let's write some names out. Mercury 2 iodide. Well, you like it when you're looking at the name because you know the ions. Mercury 2, Hg2+. I remember mercury is Hg, not Mg. Mg is magnesium. Don't mix them up. Iodide is 1- because it is in column 7A. Now you do your charge balancing. The least common multiple of 2 and 1 is 2. So you take one mercury 2 ion, you take two iodide ions. Silver nitride. Silver is one you have to memorize. Silver is 1+. Nitride, 3- because it's in column 5A. Now do your charge balancing. What is the least common multiple of 1 and 3? It's 3. So Ag3N. You get 3 silver ions, 1 nitride ion. Chromium 3 sulfide. Chromium 3. You know the charge, it's Cr3+. Sulfide is in column 6A, so it's 2-. The least common multiple of 3 and 2 is 6. So you need 2 chromiums and 3 sulfides. The stock number is only put into the name. The stock number is not put into the chemical formula.